To watch more videos and support our channel, Dalit Poetry and Literature, please subscribe.
Sulochana Bai Dongre, deceased. Srimati Sulochana Bai Dongre was born in a wealthy family in a village called Nagapur on 6 November 1919. Her father, Sri Bansode Patil, was a respected resident of the village. He looked after his agricultural lands and gave generous help to the poor and needy. People who were active in Baba Saheb's movement would often visit his house. He was too an activist of the movement, and many meetings and discussions were held at his house. Sulochana Bai witnessed all this from her childhood. Since there was no school in Nagpur, she went to stay with her maternal uncle G.D. Borkar in Indore for her early schooling. Since Borkar was a Brahmo Samajist, Sulochana Bai had the opportunity of interacting with the upper class person who visited him. When she was in the 8th class at school, Sulochana Bai was married to Sadashiv Rao Dongre, the eldest son of Chandrabhanji Dongre, the postmaster of Amravati. After her marriage, she indicated to her father-in-law that she wished to study further. Since he was an educated man, he raised no objection. At the time, Sulochana Bai's husband was studying in Ferguson College in Pune. Sulochana Bai completed her matriculation and went on to study further at Morris College in Nagpur, where she passed the intermediate examination. During this period, she worked for some time as superintendent of the depressed classes girls hostel newly opened in Gokulpet area of Nagpur. While managing the hostel, she gave guidance to several girls striving to get an education, among whom was Sugandha Shende. She often helped untouchable girls with their day-to-day problems and is still remembered by her students. Since her husband and her father were both involved in the Baba Saheb's movement, Sulochana Bai developed an interest in social work. She began to attend meetings and even to give speeches on occasion. Sulochana Bai was good-looking and delicate in her appearance, and she dressed well. Her husband was a recruiting officer, and his brother Jairam Bansode was active in the Samata Sainik Dal. She brought up two children, a boy and a girl, while doing a social work, balancing her two responsibilities in an admirable fashion. In Nagpur, she was often accompanied to meetings by Zaibai Chaudhary. She expressed her views clearly and firmly, and was able to make an impression on audiences. Having a philanthropic, independent, and dignified nature, Sulochana Bai gained tremendous self-confidence after she entered Baba Saheb's movement, and soon Baba himself heard about her. She was asked to chair a women's conference of the All India Scheduled Caste Federation in 1942. She gave an inspiring speech before the 25,000 women assembled from different parts of the country in the presence of Baba Saheb. Later, she was invited to speak at various places in Maharashtra. In those days, when Dalit society was still very backward, Bai spoke of social renaissance. She attended the women's conference in Kanpur in Uttar Pradesh in 1944. Sulochana Bai's life is an example of how Dalit women, till then silent and helpless, were becoming articulate and able to hold large audiences with their speeches. This was the influence of Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Sulochana Bai was completely dedicated to her work, and when involved in any activity, she did not care about her health. Varale writes about her thus: Sulochana Bai Dongre, chairperson of the Women's Conference of the Scheduled Caste Federation, was extremely cooperative and devoted to her duty. On the first day of the conference, she stayed up all night with all other women activists writing out the resolutions of the Women's Conference.